I'm here with the new WBC World Champion, Mia St. John. So Mia, first of all, congratulations on your huge victory against Christy Martin. Walk me through
Thank
that victory.
Thank you. Well, you know, I've waited 16 years, actually 10 years from the rematch. 16 years.
Sorry.
Okay. 16 years ago, I said I want to fight Christy Martin and get the WBC World Championship, and I finally conquered my dream, and there's just nowhere to go from here. I mean, there's nowhere to go but down, so I don't know. So that's why I'm considering retiring, but I don't know, because, you know, fighters, like, it's just so hard.
It's very really difficult hard. Because you still have that fire and you just won, so you're like, you could do it again. But I just came back from the Olympics, and the biggest thing in the Olympics in boxing was the women's boxing. Did you know that? It was just a crazy...
Oh, yeah. And I'm so happy for the women, and it's about time. And I hope that that will do something for maybe the professionals, give us some more limelight. But, you know, my day was back in the 90s. That was my prime. And it's time for these new girls to take over and do something new. And so we'll see.
Speaking of the new girls, Kaliesha West, right here from Southern California. She's fighting on a Shane Mosley card. What do you think of Kaliesha?
Love Kaliesha. Kaliesha was my sparring partner for a long time, and she's one of the best. She really is. She's fast, she's strong, she's technical. She's what I like to call the female Tommy Hearns. You know, she's a boxer puncher, which is very difficult to do. But she just has a knack for it.
We're here at a K1 event today. They put you on stage. Your crowd went crazy. Tell me, how did you get involved with K1?
Well, I got a call shortly after the Christy Martin fight a couple weeks ago from my attorney, who said there's a new series called K1 Rising. It's going to be on Spike TV. Would you like to commentate? And so shortly thereafter, we signed the deal, and I'm on board. So it was really a godsend, because it helps me look at retirement a bit easier, knowing that I have something else to look forward to. And this is so exciting, because martial arts was my first love.
Tell me about that. You grew up in Northern California.
Yeah, well, no. I was born in San Francisco, but I've lived most of my life in L.A. County. But I started Taekwondo when I was 6 years old, and I spent 23 years in that sport, and then obviously the last 16 years in boxing. So the martial arts is really my first love.
What was it like working with Brandon Krause, a very talented trainer? A lot of people are getting to know him now. He just won the title with you. And what was it like to work with him for this camp?
Brandon was amazing. And, you know, he's an unknown trainer. Obviously, he's not one of the famous trainers. But he's just as good, if not better. Because he really knew my style and knew what I needed to improve. I'm more of a boxer. And he added the punching to it. So I could mimic more like a Tommy Hearns. And he was able to accomplish that. And I'm such a stubborn fighter, so if you can accomplish anything with me, you're doing good. And he did.
One thing that some people know about you, some people don't, you're a champion for many causes, but one cause that's close to your heart is about people with mental problems, raising awareness, helping. Tell me about that, and where can people get more information?
Well, my foundation is called El Saber Es Poder, which means knowledge is power. You can go to miasaintjohnfoundation.org. And we do a lot for Latinos here in the United States, as well as Mexico, academically, mental health, fitness, nutrition. And that's my main love. You know, above all, first and foremost, that's the love of my life. That's what I feel I was put on this earth to do. And I look at boxing as simply a vehicle to enable me to do this.
Is there anything, looking back at your 16 years, that you would have changed right now if you could?
Nothing. Everything in my 16-year career went according to plan. The plan of the universe. It was all meant to be, and there's nothing that... If I died today, I conquered every dream I ever had for myself. Yeah, hope not, knock on wood. But if I did, you know, I did everything that I set out to do.
You worked with Robert Garcia before he became the household name. Right now, he's considered by many the best trainer in the world of boxing.
Yeah.
What do you say about his success?
Oh, he's amazing. You know, I'll always love Robert. You know, he trained me for the first Christy Martin fight. I spent many years with him and his father, actually. And all the guys at La Colonia in Oxnard. And, you know, I love him. What can I say? You know, he's He'll always be very dear to me.
And my last question, I have to ask you this. Right now it's very popular with tennis stars, with their look to make them popular. You have Ronda Rousey, but you were one of the originals that you not only attracted, but you could fight. Right. How did you handle that from both worlds?
Well, you know, I mean, I guess the same way every other athlete, like you said, does. I mean, look at David Beckham. I mean, we know he's a soccer player, but yeah, we see him nude everywhere on every magazine, you know, which is great. He's hot, you know. So I'm not really doing anything new. Athletes have been doing this for years. Oscar De La Hoya, the Golden Boy. You know, a lot of athletes have done it and will continue to do it. You know, it's just part of the business. We live in a capitalist country, and that enables us to, you know, to promote ourselves any way we can.
There you have it. And my last thing, who's your favorite boxer in the world today? I have to notice.
Oh, goodness. You know, as far as purely from a boxing standpoint, it would have to be Tommy, the Hitman Hearns. And from a social perspective, I love Oscar De La Hoya for all that he's done for the community, for the people. That's my inspiration and my motivation for all that I do with my foundation.
And Oscar is a great dude too. So.
Oh, he is. He's a great guy, yeah. But if you're talking purely boxing, obviously the Hitman.
But what about from the active guys? The Mayweather, the Pacquiao, is it someone else? The Sergio Martinez, the Canelo?
You know, I love all those guys. They're all great. But you know, I'm old school. So I'm following the old guys.
There you have it. Make sure to look out for Mia St. John, her website, and all the great work she does in the community. And right now, she's the champion. Stay tuned. For ESNEWS.com, I'm Melissa Back reporting. And of course, she's going to be commentating this weekend on the K1 fights.